Hello everyone, this is Ryan Smith, one of the authors of The Natural Aquarium, A Complete Guide, and today we're going out to a place I found on iNaturalist. I was looking for bacopa, and I happened to find that there was somewhat near me in this drainage ditch here on the side of a six-lane road there. And who could pass up free plants, right? So, let's have a look, see what's out there. But first, made sure to bring along my trusty seek guide. And here we are, inside the drainage ditch. As you can tell, 100% man-made channel here. Right down in the middle of Southern California, where it doesn't really rain often, but yet, here we find water. And of course, where there's water, there's life. Look at the wide variety of plants available. Oh, gorgeous. So much better than looking at the brown and concrete scapes that are normally abound in the city. And we're lucky today because look, a heron. And look, it has something in its beak. What could it be? Oh, it's still moving. Look at that. It's a crayfish. He's taking his time on that one. Oh, and down it goes. Nature. It's all around you. Well, let's get down to business. First things first, a little bit of safety for me. I tend to cut my hands a lot, so I'm wearing a glove because this is a drainage ditch after all. And I figured I might identify some of the plants that I'm coming across, and of course the seek app that I downloaded helps me. There's some watercress. And right next to it, oh, more watercress, of course. And then, wait, what's this? It's the bacopa that we came for. There's various other things around here as well. I don't even know what that one is. What else can we find? Huh. Makes sense being curled. Oh, and look at this. A little celery for your dinner, perhaps. Not that I would eat out of a drainage ditch. There's more bacopa poking up everywhere. What else can we find? Burr clover. That's not fun. There's some more of that plant I have no idea about. And celery again. Let's take a look at the stalk here. It's getting pretty thick there. And then I found some tracks. Perhaps more heron? Perhaps a raccoon. Even more raccoon? If you've got a good guess, let me know in the comments. And then, unfortunately, I was reminded that I'm not entirely surrounded by nature. There's plenty of evidence of humans leaving their waste where it shouldn't be. Hopefully we can do better. Back to exploring. I love these little pools that are made by different plants and elevation. They harbor so much life in them. The plants themselves will catch other plants and make new habitats for them, or outcompete them. And then, there's so many little things that can be found in these pools. There's a bladder snail. These are fun little friends to take into your aquarium. They'll help you clean the glass and any other little things left about. What's this? It's moving. Yes, it's an amphipod. And, they are quite fast. Well, I suppose it's time to gather some things. I always bring along a trusty jar. And of course, for your jar, you want just a small handful of black and brown leaves from the bottom of that body of water. And of course, you'll want some of the water to go along as well. And of course, we must get some of that bacopa that we were originally here for. Just a couple sprigs will do. There's one. And here's two. And sometimes it's good to diversify your collection sites. Why not get a little stuff from here, too? One last look at the beautiful drainage ditch. And now let's see what we've got now that we're back home. What could be inside? At first glance, I've now noticed that not only have I collected leaves, but I've collected a crayfish exoskeleton as well. Movement. Do you see them? We have small friends in here. Yes, there's definite movement in here. We should probably go in for a closer look to see what we have. I've spotted something right there. It's moving in that tiny piece of debris. Perhaps if we're patient, it'll come out. There it is. Let's go in for a closer look. Ah, yes. I see it now. The structure resembles a diatom. What else do we have in here? Ah, yes. Ostracods. Peculiar little organism inside of a kidney bean shell. You can see his organs moving on the inside. And then a moena. Ah, yes. Cousin of the Daphnia, catching food with his little arms. And it all get passed down here, where eventually it'll be digested. Look at him go. And a copepod. The little cyclops of the container. And, of course, here's that amphipod that we saw earlier. I was able to pin him down so that he was not as fast this time. They're really quite handy with those little claws. Able to pick apart leaves and digest them. They're known as shredders because of this activity. Yes, all this life was found in a drainage ditch on the side of a road. And you too could bring it home for your jars. Stay curious. Come join us on the Father Fish Discord and explore the natural aquarium as nature intended. Farewell.